Hello. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to create a giving form. Giving forms are donation forms that can be embedded on your website. Fundraise's giving forms are highly configurable, allowing you to build custom donation experiences and control the brand elements of your forms. Before we jump into creating a giving form, let's take a look at a live example. This donation page has a clear and inviting donation button. When we click to donate, the giving form opens full screen on the page for a user-friendly donation process. The pop-up form is suggested for most use cases, but you can also embed the form directly into your page layout. In another lesson, we'll walk through the entire donation flow from your donor's perspective. Today, we're going to start inside Fundraise's platform and create a form just like the one you see here. Alrighty, inside Fundraise's platform, access giving forms by clicking Giving Forms in the side menu. You'll land on a paginated table of your forms. Here, you see helpful information for each form, including the amount raised through the form, the count of donors, the count of one-time and recurring transactions, and the goal progress. In the Actions menu, at the right of each row, click to edit or archive a giving form. And of course, at the top of the page, you can click to create a new giving form. When you click to create a new form, a giving form editor profile will open. The form editor has three tabs: settings, design, and publish. Use settings to configure everything from payment methods to the donation receipt email. In design, you'll configure the form's brand elements like logo and color. From the publish tab, you can grab the code needed to embed your form on your website. In the rest of this lesson, we'll walk through each form configuration line by line, so get comfy. But before we dig in, it's great to know that you can clone any previous form from the Actions menu at the top right. Okay, let's start with settings. In the Settings tab, there are several pages of configurations. First up is General, where you can edit the overall settings for this form. Form name is an internal name to help your team stay organized. Goal amount will help your team track your progress. Next, in Contact Information, make the phone number and physical address fields hidden, optional, or required for your donors. If you choose to allow institution contacts, your donor will be able to declare that the donation is from an institution, as well as select the institution type and enter the institution name. Next, tags. When tags are added to a giving form, they'll be automatically applied to any supporters or transactions passing through this form. Tags are very helpful as they can be used to create filtered lists of supporters or transactions. To add tags, just enter a hash symbol followed by the tag. Add multiple tags if you like. Google reCAPTCHA is a tool used to mitigate transaction fraud, a common issue for nonprofit donation forms. There are several methods Fundraise uses to mitigate fraud on your forms, but we highly recommend enabling Google reCAPTCHA. Each giving form has a checkbox to collect positive marketing consent from your donors. This is required in many locations. While this checkbox cannot be removed, you can default the marketing consent checkbox to true or checked. Finally, you can edit the form version in the general section. In nearly all cases, your form should be set to version 2. Form version 1 is a legacy form and deprecated version that does not have advanced features like ticketing or Apple Pay. Now, let's click into the ticket section. Here, you can add tickets to your giving form. Just click Add Ticket to search and select the tickets you'd like to add. After your tickets are added to the list, you can change the order the tickets display on the form. Tickets are a component of Fundraise's event feature, which we'll cover in depth in another lesson. When you add tickets to the form, a few things happen. First, the tickets are added to the first page of the form. Second, you can choose to show an additional donation ask after your guest has selected their tickets. If you add a donation ask to a ticket form, it will be optional for your donors. Questions. To add a custom question to the form, click Add Question. Search and select an existing question or create a new question. Questions are great if you need to collect additional information from a donor, like their t-shirt size. Just like tickets, you can change the order that your questions are displayed on the form. Moving on to payments, probably the most important settings for your form. The ask amount represents your donation amount options. In almost all cases, you'll use a suggested ask type, which allows you to customize four amount buttons. You can also default the amount that the form opens with by clicking Prefill. If you need to collect a single amount as a payment or membership fee, select the required ask amount type and enter the specific amount. Now, this will be the only amount available on your donation form. Activate as many payment methods as needed, including card, e-check, Bitcoin, Apple Pay, and PayPal. The payment methods available in your account are based on the gateways you've added. Consult our documentation to learn more about gateways and payment methods. Because PayPal donations are finalized on PayPal's website, the PayPal redirect is the URL that we will direct your donors to after they successfully complete their donation on PayPal. Next, frequency. You can allow your donors to select a frequency for their donation. Recurring giving is a very effective tool to increase revenue. If you don't have a monthly donor program, we highly suggest you start one. We recommend always including a one-time and monthly option. Other strategies may call for weekly, quarterly, or yearly. Transaction options are additional fields you can choose to show or hide. With dedications, your donors can dedicate their gift to a loved one or someone who inspired their donation. Your donor will be able to select a dedication type and enter a name, email address, and message. If a dedication email address is provided, we'll send an email with details about the dedication to the dedicatee. If you allow donors to give anonymously, they can choose to hide their name from public donation feeds on campaign sites. We suggest always allowing for anonymous donations. Your team will still be able to view the donor's name and contact details in the back end. Donors can also leave a comment with their donation. To use Company Match, you'll need to activate the Double the Donation integration. Thousands of companies match their employees' donations, so by enabling Company Match, you can collect match information from donors and begin the matching process right from the donation. This is a revenue booster and a time saver. We'll cover allocations in another course, so we won't explain them in detail in this lesson. Here, you can add one or many allocations to the form. You can also change the order of the allocation selection list. Next, let's look at the donation receipt sent by email. Each giving form has its own receipt template. Click to preview your receipt template, which includes important information like donation details, organization name, organization ID number, and address. Time to talk about items you can customize on the receipt. The from address is the email address that this email will be sent from. It's a good idea to use a general address for this, like donations@your.org. You can add multiple sending addresses in your platform settings. Enter a subject line. We suggest something like thank you for your donation. Each receipt can also display your logo. Pro tip, link this logo image to your website. And finally, write custom body content to thank your donors or provide more information about their donation. This is advanced, but you can do it. Insert data merge tags to personalize your donation receipt. For example, add a donor's name or details about their donation into the email body. Consult our documentation to see all the merge tags available. Next, let's look at the brand elements of the form. Click Design in the top bar to open your design options. Here you'll see editable items on the left and a design preview on the right. The design preview isn't actually your live form, it's just a default view to preview your design edits. Give your form a headline that will appear with the pop-up version of the form. If you don't want a headline, just leave this field blank. Next, colors for your form. You can edit the pop-up background color, headline color, and button text color. We suggest a darker background with your primary brand color for the button. Add a logo to your form. A consistent brand experience is a big part of encouraging donor trust online. Now that the form's configured with the desired settings and design, it's time to publish the form on your website. On the publish page, you'll see a few options. The button launcher allows you to embed a button on your site that will launch a pop-up form. This is the recommended option in most cases. The placed form option will allow you to embed the form directly in your page layout. To embed a form, you must copy each element of the form code and place it into your website. In another lesson, we'll talk in detail about how to embed your giving forms. In most cases, you need to share this code with your web developer. Congratulations for completing this lesson. It's a lot of information. The giving form is one of the most fundamental tools you'll rely on from Fundraise, so it's good to know all of the options it provides. See you soon.